After a 250-kilometer reconnaissance flight, Chris Aultman lands on the Bob Barker to give details about a possible target.
What's the harpoon ship doing?
Near way back.
Barely see it.
It's 3 miles away, yeah. Just keep an eye on him. The problem with having the helicopter on board is that Yoshimaru number 3 can actually put their water cannons on the helicopter, and that way they can damage the helicopter.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, mate.
Good to
see you.
Good to be seen. Just keep an eye on them. They look like they were coming in closer.
Although the whaling fleet has never actually sprayed the aircraft before, the Sea Shepherds fear that the whalers will blast the helicopter with their water cannons.
So you're saying it's mostly ice around us?
Yeah, so basically, everything over here is just ice.
Okay.
As far as the eye can see, and this is a little false bay.
Yep.
I mean, it's a big body of water. It's got to be 25, 30 miles across. And
that's really big, yeah. So they could actually be in here.
They could. Regrettably, the Nishimar could have been sitting right there, and we wouldn't have seen it.
Yep. When you get back to the Steve, tell Paul to move to this side. And if they're trying to get out, looking at the ice chart, this is the only exit from this bay.
Right, yeah.
Speed to 10.
Hang on. Let's get a target on here.
I can just see them. It's fogging the distance, but
they're in the other way. Always something.
We'll be up shortly. Last year, it became very clear that they wanted to take the helicopter out of action by hitting it with the water cannons. So as a result, I give them a little extra room now, just because I just don't trust them.
Bit more
pitch, 80. Take her on our port side, Peter.
Helicopter, Bob Barker.
Bob Barker Bridge, helicopter.
Yeah, pretty close. Take off whenever you're ready.
We're ready to go. Here we
go. What the hell was that?
Warning! Warning!
He's rocked back again.
80%.
80%.
Can you take off, Owen? Oh, come on. She's gonna start.
It's come around the port.
We'll have to hose you to fend you off. Bridge.
Go ahead, man.
Could you come up here real quick? Hey, bro.
Let me get that line in the water now if they're going to be trailing us from astern. Maybe like 20 meters off the stern.
Okay.
We're just running the stern line out. It prevents the harpoon boat from getting too close to the stern.
Should do a run.
Turning.
At least they think they are. Excellent.
Hey, Pots, you can ask your crew to stand down.
Okay, thanks.
I don't like this fog. You should let the Bob know that the fog's here in case...
In case Chris decides to come back?
Yeah, I mean, he might have to stay there. It's really Chris's call, but I don't think he'll want to come in on... Just tell him it's a thick fog. We'll let him know as soon as it lifts.
Barker, this is Alex.
Doug speaking.
Yeah, Alex,
can you let the helicopter know that we're currently in fog?
Okay, helicopter.
The helicopter's up.
Radio broken, Chris chooses to fly back to the Steve Irwin's last known location.
Steve Irwin Bridge, Steve Irwin Bridge, helicopter, over.
But the Steve Irwin is no longer there.
Bob Barker Bridge, Bob Barker Bridge, helicopter on airbag.